Welcome to Advanced Internal Martial Art, Course 1, Lesson 1. The One-Point Mind. The goal of this course is through a series of lessons to give you everything you need to become an internal martial art master. After completing this course and through a series of lessons, you will be able to perform demonstrations like the ones you are watching now. This is one of the main lessons that will help you learn to channel your power and technique through a highly focused line. However, before we get into the lesson, this is a good place to ask yourself if you are ready for the lesson that follows. It's quite okay if you aren't quite ready. We can fix that over time. But keep it in mind that to fully appreciate the lesson that follows, you should be able to perform like the practitioner shown here. For maximum success with this lesson, you should already be familiar with that vertical line, how to find it and work with it within your own body. This is the next step to show, if you have that vertical line understanding, then you can really work with it, is to see if the muscles around the spine and around the body are loose enough to where that center line can become dominant. Being able to do those two things just at the same time puts you in the right spot to get the most benefit from the material that follows. Test yourself by relaxing the muscles along the spine as you stay focused on and move in reference to that vertical line. But don't worry if you can't quite get that vertical line ability right away. Just refer back to the test in the future. It's a great indicator of your understanding of two essential points that makes everything else work. Those two points: first, working with the vertical line, and then relaxing the muscles around the spine. Finding the one-point mind. A one-point mind training has to do with learning to bring your total mind, body, and attention to one point. A big part of it has to do with efficiency and getting rid of excess wasted motion that disturbs your ability to focus that intention to a single point. Some of the greatest masters had this ability to focus their entire willpower, mind, and physical mechanics to that single point. In this research, we want to share what we learned about that and how to help you also attain that kind of one-point mind, intention, concentration, and body mechanics unity. Demonstrations you see here are products of one-point mind training. The lesson begins with studying how to make your body more efficient and unified. But what exactly is the one-point mind? The one-point mind is a way of training focus and tension and the nervous system to work together with extreme efficiency. Simply stated, it's the concentration of intention that interacts with the nervous system and physical mechanics. How? We developed one-point mind training at Chi Arts. Helps us understand the process. Our one-point mind training was inspired by Xing Yi's spirit training. Developing focused power through the spirit requires the practitioner to let go of all unnecessary tension while focusing unified body mechanics to a single point.
The common move of the spirit is to keep on target as fit as possible, not wavering, then you turn and bend, turn. Whole body commands. So Michael, commands typically. Might look like this. His weapon working is in it. He's coming at me. I want to be able to take this weapon.
The goal is to eliminate inefficiency.
He's coming at me. turning foot, and ending up, maybe here, dropping. Feel that new turn, the power of the thrust is there, working forward.
As some of us got better with a one-point mind skill development, we found that the principle could be applied to other combat skills. For us, it became the ultimate definition of internal martial art mastery. As we developed the ability to lightly touch and take out an opponent, it became the focus of attention and an exciting part of our training.
Okay, dude. Oh, shit.
As we learned to control an opponent with the lightest touch, it became very exciting. This knowledge completely changed our training. It became the center of our training, which we applied everywhere we could.
Okay, this is a strong position there. The ideal contact point between me and my opponent is this point right here. So if he's pushing here, push him in.
This application of one-point mind applies to Bagua. Once we really got the notion that one-point mind was the ultimate definition of mastery, it completely changed the way we practiced. One-point mind focus to a single point. The remainder of the body, to the extent possible, relaxes all unnecessary tension. A new kind of biophysical mechanics starts to emerge. Then get ready for something big. You are about to touch real magic as your intention merges with the body's physical mechanics. Once you accept it for the first time, you will expect nothing less from
the
practice.
To do first. One hand only, please. Go ahead. I want you to feel, push each other, that angle where you touch and you cut off their power.
Congratulations, you have just entered a new era in your martial art training. Me, it became the ultimate definition of mastery. With one-point mind, there is mastery, but without it, there is no mastery.
Coil, bring that coil through the body.
Incredible how the one-point mind training allows you to move light and yet at the same time powerfully. Since learning this principle, I've never been beaten at push hands. I have been beaten with push hands by some of my students who also learned the principles that we talk about in this course. It also should be pointed out that the one-point mind gives you an incredible advantage in practices such as push hands, since you have the ability to make yourself tense or full or empty anywhere in your body at will. You are a very difficult target to get someone to put force on.
I've increased the ability to sense my opponent's intention, push as he's moving on me. Where is he at? Where's his center? How can I move?
When you get this skill, you'll find that your opponent gets very frustrated.
Move him a little bit off balance. Push me hard. He can't quite get a level.
The big problem is that most students do not move efficiently. As seen in this student's posture and alignment, there are places in his body that the shoulders rise or the knees go out of whack. And these little misalignments break the body's overall efficiency. Let's look at some examples of better and less efficiency. In this example of less efficiency and lower level body mechanics, watch the student's shoulders swing back and forth. In the brief clip that follows, watch the red arrow very closely.
I'm going to go right, straight, left, hit, move, move.
Now compare that to the way I punch in the background. Note that I use a counterforce method that unifies the body's entire power. Note that I am not throwing the shoulders forward, but instead I am coiling into the body where it aligns and brings the whole body center into the punch. Once again. The videos that follow include me working with some students to get them to change from a swinging back and forth shoulder and trapezius muscle dominance to what is referred to as dragon back, where the muscles are used in a coiling, more vertical line and through more of the body. This student is typical of many, where it's challenging to get him to change from a back-and-forth teeter-totter-like swing to a serpentine-like coil through the body.
So it stretches the pose?
Yeah, I mean, it's not just the shoulder. I mean, it's just the shoulder.
Yeah, you're like there in between this point. Okay, this point here. Gonna stretch it, push it, and then exercise that. Getting a little bit there.
The problem is that for a long time the student relied on swinging the shoulder to get power, and changing to a new habit does take time. Here, I demonstrate the principle for the camera.
This is very important skill. I think you can't really go into the internal power release and other movements on a vertical level without understanding how to change from that shoulder side to side to that vertical coiling line. The student still had problems doing it. He's still moving side to side instead of like up in a coil through the body. I hope this is helpful to you. I think it will be.
Watch this more advanced student as he changes from a default lean back posture to the coiling dragon back. Notice this advanced practitioner's default way of standing before the dragon back. And then the changes he goes through as he trains his body to go into the dragon back. Here he's not quite getting it. And then he uses a wall to push his body back and develop the dragon back. And here he's got it. And look at the different appearance from the previous default position. And then finally, we see some good examples of him being able to apply the dragon back. Here's a video of the training where the student first shows the default position before the dragon back was applied. And then the dragon back was applied to his work by pushing against the wall and pushing the upper part of the back backwards to align that vertical serpentine kind of line.
Push your back back. You know what? There's a spot between in the upper back, like right here, by the backside, where you like lock it. And I'm getting you to push that spine backwards. Oh, like that.
Oh, I could do this.
And here the student starts to get the feeling of the dragon back and then put it into different kinds of training postures and strikes that he was working with.
Come on. You can do it on the wall, yeah, like that. Now punch from there. Look at that. And it solved the release problem too, huh?
Yeah, once the student got the dragon back pretty well in there, he was able to apply it to a whole bunch of techniques and improves his speed and connection.
The next step is to train intention and body mechanics to merge to a single point.
Adapted from our research with the Xing Yi spear, the best way to teach that skill, that one-point mind skill, is through stick training. We found that when a stick or other object is held in one spot, that when held over time, excess and inefficient points in the body are released. This is a very powerful way to train your concentration to merge with your biomechanics. However, there's another problem we had to solve. We found that the person holding the stick, the receiver, if you will, of the stick force, of stick alignment, moves too much. Even if they're trying not to, they still move, and that causes too much of a challenge to the student learning the skill to really get that new feeling and let go of tension. So the solution was to hold the stick in one spot against the wall. That allows you to be able to affect that same change you need with barely holding the weapon or stick or knife or whatever it might be. As you concentrate the power and you release all of the tension, it becomes quite incredible. Eventually that translates into power to one point with very little effort or tension in the body, as everything becomes focused to that single point. And it's incredible when you see that same power translate to other mediums like, say, a knife.
You use that connection through our body and are able to push and effortlessly still hold on. We would be able to use that connection with any kind of weapon we use. And so, this being a blade, very sharp, real cold steel blade, it's moving. Using that connection all the way through. And so, even with something as small as this, you can push on it, right? You can move, push back, and still have that connection. And that transfers into anything I do.
The result is a tremendous amount of power to one point with very light and quick movements. Power with lightness becomes very deadly. So now we begin the study of how exercises that help you develop your mind focus to that one point. Since our goal is to be able to hold the object, the weapon, the stick, very lightly with your hand, yet put the power up forward, we needed another way. We found a better way to do it, and that was by using a piece of paper held lightly on the wall, not leaned against, but very lightly, enough to where you can have the mind and attention and your hands relax as you hold the object up, and then it'll start to throb as your attention and blood flow changes. And then you'll know that you get it when you feel the changes in your hands. Stick training.
This exercise is training with the staff and actually working the body and the mind together and putting your mind into the staff, at the end of the staff, and working with muscle connections to make that connection great as it can be. The method we use to train this technique is putting your mind against the end of the staff with a piece of paper. We're going to put it against the wall and using the end of the staff with not enough force to penetrate the piece of paper.
Start by holding the stick against a lightweight object against the wall for a few minutes at a time. Hold the stick as light as possible.
Note, corrected here by edit, we found that the stick held horizontally produces better results.
Do not lean on the object on the wall. The magic time for your body to release bad habit tension is 10 minutes. That means that your best training will take place between 10 and 25 minutes.
Of course, you will work on this 10 to 25 minute time guidance gradually and over a long period of time, usually between 3 and 9 months. Be gentle on yourself. Do not expect to do it in 1 week or two.
Exercises and stretches. So we use different exercises and stretches. One stretch I like is holding it out. And you don't necessarily need to grip it, the staff, like you would when you tense up and swing a baseball bat, but rather a lightness and a touch. And that this is what we train with in using this piece of paper and the delicateness that ensues when you just use touch. And what we're doing here is I'm connecting, I'm feeling it going all the way down through my arms, into my lats, down in the pelvic, and all the way down into my leg, and finally into the ground. And I'm putting my mind at the end of the staff. And what that's doing is training a lightness, but at the same time training our muscles to have the connected feeling that you want to feel when using the staff. And there's different positions in which you use this. Train different muscles, and the whole time feeling a connection, but not enough force again to rip the paper.
As illustrated here, a great aid to your practice is the help of a training partner who taps or lightly touches the end of the staff. This will help you identify tense points in your body that need to be released.
Test the staff, what we're doing, we're finding that connection, that light connection. What we're doing is finding this connection. At the end. Of the staff.
More force on it, Jason. Let's see how connected is he right now.
Oh, it's pretty solid. It's real solid, actually.
Yeah, you can put a little more force there if you want that.
And what we do, we don't even have to use a wide grip like swinging a baseball bat, because when you find the connection, you use the muscle body connectivity and put our mind at the end at the same time. Really. Accomplish great feats.
Next, you will be able to apply the skill you learned to punching and other strikes.
The result is that every little touch will have a tremendous effect on your opponent.
At advanced levels, your power becomes more and more effortless as you coil through the body and touch with less and less effort, and you present a tremendous amount of force.
So here, and grab here. Okay, this is a reverse intro shot. See y'all. You okay?
Yes, sir.
Here.
Now we have an overview of the important points that were covered in this lesson. In the beginning of this lesson, we covered the prerequisite of manifesting tense centerline principles while other muscles are relaxed. Next, we defined the one-point mind as the merging of body mechanics and intention brought to a single focus point. Then we covered efficiency. The expression of power is related to efficient body mechanics and how to understand that efficiency in motion and stillness. Next, we covered the amazing principle of the dragon back and how changing from a shoulder swing to a more fluid power that coils through the back is more powerful and effective. Finally, we covered stick training, which teaches you to focus your body mechanics, alignment, and tension to a single point. Our goal has been to give you the secret power of the masters, and we believe that internal martial art true masters like Sun Lutang, shown in this picture, illustrates for us and has left us the secret of one-point mind training, which is coiled through the whole body. I believe that one-point training, where the mind is focused one point, where everything else relaxed, is the true secret of internal martial arts. And we want you to get it. It changes everything. An important note, although this lesson has covered the essential of biomechanics of the one-point mind, there are mental, emotional, and energetic aspects of the practice that were not covered. They will be presented in a future video. The following is a demonstration of a fluid one-point mind demonstration with mental, emotional elements added. It took place at our instructor mountain cabin retreat. Sorry, the lighting is poor.
Appreciate your best.
What point is it?